هل لاحظت اختلافا في موقف الانجليز اتجاه المسلمين منذ انضمام محمد صلاح الى ليفربول؟
Yes. Definitely, because he, when he scores the goals, you know, he's winning titles, he's winning trophies. People are happy. We see in the stadiums as well now. They, you know, a lot of stadiums are making prayer rooms for Muslims. A lot of stadiums are now providing halal food for the Muslims. We feel more inclusive now. We feel more part of the, you know, the fans. When you go to the stadium, you know, before, I don't think I could go to stadium with a jubba, and now sometimes I go to the stadium with jubba, and alhamdulillah, very you know. I remember recently I went to one game, and I was wearing my jubba because I went straight after salah, so I didn't have time to change. I went in the jubba. As I approached the stadium, we went inside, and the steward came, and the steward said, "When it's prayer time, the prayer hall is downstairs. You take a left and you go straight and take a right." So he recognized me as a Muslim, and he immediately, you know, told me about the salah. You know, you go there and you pray there. So alhamdulillah, it was, you know, very accommodating.
مؤخرا في لقاء تلفزيوني سئل محمد صلاح خلال مقابلة عن الكحول، تلقى الكثير من الانتقادات في مصر لأنه لم يقل أنها حرام نصا. رأيك في إجابته إيه؟ وشايف رد الفعل الانتقادات ده إزاي؟
Good question, mashallah. Well, like, first of all, we need to realize Muhammad Salah, he gave opinion. You know, everybody has their opinions. Maybe he there was a political side to it as well. I'm not sure, wallahu alam. But the question as well was not very clear. The question was not, is alcohol halal or is alcohol haram? The question was also, you know, going around the bush. So Salah also answered it in the same manner as well. And he said, I don't feel like it. Maybe he doesn't feel like it in this world because he's going to feel like it in Jannah, inshallah. So that's why maybe he could say that.
هل كانت لديك مواقف مضحكة أو حكايات مع محمد صلاح وساديو ماني؟
كولو توري, he was very funny. You know, he in his nature, he was just naturally funny. You know, even when Kolo Touré was, even when he was serious, he was still funny. So I have some, you know, funny moments with him. The first time I met Kolo Touré, I was doing the khutbah. So I was on the minbar and I was giving the khutbah, and Kolo Touré, he walked into the prayer room. So number one, of course, he was the last person in the masjid. So he was extremely late. And then he walked in as though he was extremely early. And he came with a big, you know, funny hat, and he's just standing there looking at me in my face as I'm giving the khutbah. So I couldn't keep it in. I started also laughing in the khutbah because he was just staring at my face. So I also started smiling, and I think people look back to see who it is. And when they look back, they realize it was Kolo Touré.